Good morning. My name is Eric Gray. I'm the president of ATSSB. And on the stage, seated in front of you, are 20 of the very best jazz musicians in the state of Texas. And they have gathered here to perform and grow and enjoy each other and their clinician and the music. And that, my friends, is a tremendous feat just being here. Let's give them a hand for that. From the very beginning, we have planned this activity and this event with your students in mind, and we did not know the weight of that until we got here. I was on the elevator the other morning, and a student was on there with me. I didn't know him, he didn't know me, and he looked at me and he said, "I just want to thank you for all the work that you guys have done to make this happen, because this is truly a life-changing event." And now I know that student, and he is a trumpet player in this jazz band, Mr. Timmy Smith from Brownsboro. And that has been the consensus. That has been the general overall feeling. Thank you for allowing us to be here. And so we thank you for your presence. I'd like to recognize our jazz band organizer. Our organizers are behind the scenes working early in the morning, late in the evening. And our jazz band organizer this year has done a tremendous job, Mr. Stephen Rash. Couple of quick announcements before we get started. The recording of this concert, will be available for free on the ATSSB webpage. So after it is recorded and mastered and made to sound really nice, which it won't need much help because I've heard these guys practice, go to the ATSSB webpage and you will be able to access those recordings for free. And there's some Allstate memorabilia on sale out in the foyer directly behind you this morning. So again, thank you for being here. Our clinician this week has been just incredible, Dr. Mo Trout from Purdue University. He has a list of accolades and awards that are taking up a good portion of our program. I'm not going to read all those to you, but you can read those for yourself. I guarantee you, your students have had a great time. Again, a life-changing experience with our clinicians this week. So please, welcome to the stage the 2021 ATSSB Allstate Jazz Ensemble, Dr. Mo Trout.
All right, what a pleasure this has been this week. What an incredible bunch of students we have here to work with. Let's give them another big round of a hand. These guys have been amazing. Just phenomenal. The first piece that we played was arranged by one of the great big band arrangers probably of the last 30 years or so. His name's Les Hooper. And this was a tune called Killer Joe by the tenor saxophonist Benny Golson. You heard Timmy Smith on the trumpet, Roger Dominguez on the alto sax, and Martin Davenport on the trombone.
Yeah.
We're going to move on now with a tune that was written by Sonny Rollins, one of the really premier tenor saxophonists in the whole history of jazz. This is probably his most famous composition. It's an arrangement by Mark Taylor, and it's going to feature Josiah Ponce on the drums, Ramiro Torres on bass, Micah York on piano, and then a nice tenor saxophone battle, of course, with John Fletcher on tenor sax and Josue Molina on tenor saxophone. Here is Tenor Madness.
Thank you.
Aren't they amazing? Yeah, incredible. The next piece we'd like to play is really one of the most beautiful pieces that's come out in recent years. This is written by a gentleman who teaches at the University of North Texas now. He directs the 1 o'clock lab band, and really just one of the great writers that's out there. He's doing everything from lower level educational pieces all the way up through very contemporary and very professional works. This is a wonderful piece that he played and dedicated to a young man who was a high school student who was just the life of the party. You know, everybody loved him, and he was known for giving great hugs, but he unfortunately got a heart ailment, and his life was cut short way too soon. And so it's just an homage to this young man, and Alan Balak called it simply El Abrazo, which means hugs. We're gonna feature Micah York on piano, John Fletcher on tenor saxophone, and then you're gonna hear just some really beautiful ensemble pieces by, ensemble work by the rest of the players. Here is Alan Balak's El Abrazo.
Thank you.
Our next selection goes way back, back to the beginnings of the swing era and the beginnings of the big band as we know it. This was first recorded, or not recorded, but played by the Fletcher Henderson Orchestra in the late 1920s. And Fletcher Henderson led one of the most important big bands of the early swing era. Really became a swing band when the little-known trumpet player named Louis Armstrong joined the band, and everybody could figure out, oh, that's what you're supposed to do. Yeah, and so they became, you know, really took it to heart, and this band was an amazing band, but due to circumstances that it was an all-African-American band, they played in Harlem, and Fletcher Henderson was not a very good businessman, that the band kind of folded and wasn't able to make a go of it. But another gentleman by the name of Benny Goodman was a real fan of this band, and so he bought the whole library, you know, and did all he could to really use as many of the players as he could from this band in his recordings and later on in the band, and made many of the tunes really big hits. This is a tune that's called Big John Special. We're going to feature Timmy Smith on trumpet and Pete Jameson on alto sax and Jonathan Assisena on trumpet as well. Here is Big John's Special. Now we're going to change things again. Great trumpet player Miles Davis the Picasso of jazz, I always call him, because he was always changing his style. And everybody would love what he was doing, and by the time everybody caught up to him, he was doing something else. In 1986, he was into a totally new thing with jazz. He had really incorporated rock and electronics into his music, and he was won a Grammy for the best jazz performance in 1986 for this particular piece. It's written for by his bass player, Mr. Marcus Miller, and this arrangement that we're going to play was arranged by Michael Philip Mossman. We're going to feature Timmy Smith on trumpet again, Pete Jameson on alto sax, Roger Dominguez on alto sax, and Dylan Mitchell on trombone, and Joel Nieto on the guitar. Here is Tutu.
Thank you.
Aren't these guys great? And they're not only great musicians, they're cool too. I mean, they're having fun up here. I played the baritone. I was never cool. I was the band nerd. I guess I still am, but that's okay too. We have some kids here on the stage, some young men that are even more cool because they've been doing this all-state gig for a while now, and we would like to recognize them. Several years ago, ATSSB set up a scholarship award if you have earned all-state honors for 3 years. There's a $500 scholarship in your name. And if you made the all-state band for 4 years, there's a $2,000 scholarship in your name. And we would like to recognize those members of our all-state jazz band that have earned those awards. Three-year scholarships include Jonathan Azucena from Brazosport High School, Camden Mize, Wills Point High School, Timmy Smith, Brownsboro High School, those were our three-year scholarship award winners. We have 1 4-year scholarship award winner, and that is Josue Molina from Cornerstone Christian School. Congratulations to our scholarship winners, and we'll turn the microphone back over to Dr. Mo Trout.
Our final selection for this morning is a morning song, and it's a tune that was written by Matt Harris for a school up in the northern suburbs of Chicago, New Trier High School. And this particular piece was written to commemorate a beautiful morning in the summer in Chicago, North Shore of Chicago, where the air is crisp and clear, the birds are coming out, and you hear the crickets going, and the sun starts coming up, and then you get a nice groove that starts happening as you're driving down Lakeshore Highway. It's not really Lakeshore Road. And just really enjoying the sights of Chicago. He called this piece North Shore Morning. We're going to feature Micah York on piano, Martin Davenport on trombone, Roger Dominguez on alto sax, Jonathan Azucena on flugelhorn, John Fletcher on tenor sax, Josiah Pence on congas, and Vance Varkasia on the drum set. Here is North Shore Morning. And I would like to just take a second before we finish to thank everyone involved with this. Ken Griffin and Steve and Rash for all their help with pulling all of this together. It's just been amazing. And these incredible students. So how about one more round of applause for the incredible staff and these amazing students. And before I leave, thank you to all of the directors who have supported these students and all of the parents who've gone against the grain and let them play jazz. We really appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you.
are going to move out of the way. We're going to hand them their patches, and they're going to clear the stage and move to the front so you can meet your students there at the front. And again, we have All-State memorabilia available there at the front of the auditorium, and so be sure to visit them on your way this afternoon, this morning. Give us just a few minutes. We're going to get the setup changed, and we'll be back with the ATSSB All-State Concert Band. Good morning. Once again, I would ask you to please rise and join in with singing as our ATSSB All-State Concert Band plays our national anthem. Good morning. My name is Eric Gray. I'm the president of ATSSB, and I would like to welcome you to the 2021 ATSSB Concert Band All-State Concert. I would personally like to thank you for your presence here today and to the leadership and membership of the Association of Texas Small School Bands for the vision, leadership, and hard work it took to make this event happen. I am most proud and at the same time truly humbled to be counted as a member of this outstanding organization. This event was organized with one group of people in mind, and that is our students. This event had to happen. It had to take place, if for nothing else, but to remind us not to take for granted every opportunity we can give our students to succeed and flourish, and this is truly one of those once-in-a-lifetime opportunities. These students were born to make music, and we absolutely had to do everything in our power to make this happen. I was on the elevator with a student 2 days ago. He didn't know me, I didn't know him. He looked at me and he said, "I just want to say thank you for letting this event take place and making it take place. I'm a senior, I graduated, my life would have gone on without this, but I will remember these days for the rest of my life, and I just wanted to thank you for making it happen." I want to say thank you to Jerry Wharton and the entire band staff, band students, and administration here at Melissa for providing this perfect and impressive venue. I've discovered in our short time working together that Jerry is the dreamer of big dreams. He's been telling us for over a year, "We can do this, guys, we can do this," and he was absolutely correct, and I just want to say thank you. ATSSB is celebrating its 30th anniversary, and we had a celebration luncheon yesterday at the hotel, partially sponsored by Kaleidoscope Adventures, and we thank them for that. At that luncheon, the executive committee honored our executive secretary, Kenneth Griffin, as the first inductee in the ATSSB Hall of Fame. So if you see him after this concert is over, be sure to congratulate him on that honor. He is truly deserving. A lot of work goes on to make this happen, and we have a few more introductions to make before we listen to your students play. Our organizers are the ones that are here early, they stay late, they've been planning for months, and they're doing all of the hard work behind the scenes, so it seems only fair that we give them a moment to recognize them here on the stage. I would like to introduce our apprentice organizer, starting with percussion, Donald Myers from Redwater. Our apprentice band organizer, Jay Sutton, also from Redwater. All-state concert percussion organizer, Jim Best, Winsboro. And our all-state concert band organizer, Justin Keltner from Winona. Like I said, these folks have been going after it from well before the students showed up on Wednesday, and they'll be here after they leave getting everything taken care of. Again, thank you for being here. Your students have had a wonderful time with our clinician, and Dr. Don Lefevre is on the faculty at West Texas A&M University, and he is a household name in band halls and with band directors across the state of Texas. He's been doing this for a long time and has a whole page of accolades and awards there. And I'm going to let you read those because I've talked enough and you want to hear your kids play. They have done a great job. Please welcome to the stage the 2021 ATSSB All-State Concert Band directed by Dr. Don Lefevre. Thank you.
Wonderful overture, isn't it? Written by Alfred Reed, who at one point was one of the most prolific composers for band literature of all time. Nowadays, you almost never hear an Alfred Reed piece performed, and I wanted to introduce that piece to students. It's supposed to be about springtime and youth, and I thought, how better programmed than to kind of basically state what these students are all about, youth and going into more exciting things. This next piece is special to my heart. It's called Don Hannon. Don Hannon was my high school band director. I met Don Hannon in 1971 as a freshman, moved to Fort Stockton, a little town in South Texas. Little did I know that Don Hannon was one of the best band directors in the state, and I had a great experience. Back to old Don Hannon, my livelihood. I was going to be a business major at Texas Tech University. He called me into my office and he called me Donnie. He said, Donnie, what are you going to do next year? And I said, well, I'm going to be a business major at Tech. He said, no, you're not. I said, I'm not. He says, you're going to go to WT and you're going to be a music major. And I said, Mr. Hannah, what are you talking about? Well, guess what? That's what I did. And you know what's amazing about that story, now that I'm old enough to reflect, I should have had that conversation with my parents. So parents, I'm reminding you something today. Have that conversation. Luckily, I had a fantastic mentor in Don Hannon who steered me in the direction that I needed to be going in. Thank you, Mr. Hannon. He passed away in 2014. This wonderful piece as a tribute to Don Hannon was written by Gabe Masala. Gabe works in the UIL office in Austin. He's one of the music directors there. They have a wonderful staff in that UIL office. They organize all kinds of events throughout the year. Gabe is a big part of that. And this piece means a lot to me. And
it's been great to share it with the band and now with you. Don Hanna. Seems fair for the parents to get to be a part of the audience and for the parents to get to be a part of the performance, right? Especially after something like COVID. So all of you know this great piece by Leonard Bernstein from West Side Story, written in 1961. Mambo is a part of that. Great, great, great music. There's a place in here where we're gonna say Mambo. You'll know where. Thank you. last piece, before we play this last piece, I need to tell you a few things about your kids that you probably already know. What a wonderful group of students. Holy cow. This has been one of my favorite weeks in many, 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 many years. I really needed something like this. They really needed something like this coming off of the 18 months that we've had, right? I don't know. There's something special about music that brings us all together, lifts us up. Getting to do this event is amazing to me. And for me, for the ATSSB staff and the board, for them to have the vision and the wherewithal and knowing how much effort it was going to take to pull something like this off, they need a big pat on the back. Give those ATSSB. What a wonderful facility at Melissa. This is so beautiful. Thank all of you guys. And I want to thank all of the organizers that helped me all week. They are amazing people, every one of them. And these students, I have never worked with a better group of students in my life. And I really mean that. This piece was actually programmed years ago, and it's a piece by Brian Balmages. Wonderful piece. He's going to be conducting the next group that you're going to hear, the Symphonic Band. Well, he's a great composer, wonderful musician, and a great person. Infinite Hope, this the title, is just perfect for where we are today after 18 months of this mess that we've been through. We've lost loved ones. Some of us have gotten COVID and struggled through it, but we're prevailing. And we have a bright future ahead of us. And I think that's what this piece is all about, an infinite hope, which is a fantastic idea. And with this type of leader right here, these types of leaders, we're in good hands. We're in good hands. Thank you for being in the audience today, and thank you, band, for being the best group ever. Thank you.
Thank you.
going to reset the stage for one more band to this morning, the Symphonic Band. In between, here in just a few minutes, once we get the stage set up, we're going to announce and recognize our 3-year and 4-year scholarship recipients. We're going to have the students, as they receive their patch, go off the stage. They will meet you back in the foyer. Speaking of the foyer, there is Allstate memorabilia for sale there in the foyer, and we encourage you to go and take a look at that stuff, because it really is a once-in-a-lifetime event. A recording of these concerts will be available on the ATSSB webpage. It is a free recording. It is a free recording. It will take a little time to get mastered and mixed, and so check that webpage for a free recording of these concerts. only, and there are lots of chairs available, but we have three people in empty, two people in empty, four people in empty, so if you could squeeze together for just a little while, we'll give those folks an opportunity at the back a chance to sit down and enjoy the concert this morning. So if we would all ooch together, please. Good morning once again. Standing before you are the ATSSB 3- and 4-year scholarship award winners and a special award as well, special scholarship award. Several years ago, the leadership of ATSSB established scholarships for 3- and 4-year All-State members. 3-year All-State band members receive a $500 scholarship in their name, and 4-year All-State band members receive a $1,000 scholarship in their name. I'm sorry, $2,000 scholarship. Don't want to shortchange anybody. In addition to the 3- and 4-year All-State scholarships, the Association of Texas Small School Bands is pleased to present the Bruce Kenner Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $1,000 to Emma Ars from China Spring High School. The 2021 3-year All-State Band Scholarships include Emma Ars, China Spring High School. Lindsay Byram, London High School. Caleb Chambers, Legacy Christian Academy. Henderson Chandler, the Autry International School. Isabella Chartier, Van Alstine High School. David Dellinges, Sanger High School. Hiram Flores, Grula High School. Emmy Lovelady, Bethesda Christian School. Mason Mahi, Brazosport High School. Gerardo Rivera, Ranchview High School. Kennedy Shoemate, Seymour High School. Jimena Sotelo, Hidalgo High School. Nathaniel Sullivan, Tahoka High School. Sergio Villarreal, Grula High School. Benjamin Wendell, Needville High School. Our next group are the four-year scholarship recipients. They have made the All-State Band every year they were in high school. Charlie Baker, China Spring High School. Daniel Lander, Salado High School. Spencer Owens, Leveland High School. Michael Vara, Taft High School. One more round of applause, please, for our 3- and 4-year All-State Scholarship winners. In just a few minutes, you'll be hearing from the ATSSB Symphonic All-State Band. They are going to take the stage here shortly. And again, if there's an empty seat to your right or to your left, if you would not mind filling that seat in so our people at the back we'll have a place to sit. There are seats available throughout the entire auditorium, so don't be hesitant about coming and looking for seats. You will probably find one. Thank you. Good morning. My name is Eric Gray, and I'm the president of ATSSB, and I would like to welcome you to the 2021 ATSSB Symphonic Band All-State Concert. I would personally like to thank all of you for your presence here today, and to the leadership and membership of the Association of Texas Small School Bands for the vision, leadership, and hard work it took to make this happen. I'm most proud and, at the same time, truly humbled to be counted as a member of this outstanding organization. This event was organized with one group of people in mind, your students. This event had to happen, if for nothing else, but to remind us not to take for granted every opportunity we can give our students to succeed and flourish. And this is truly one of those once-in-a-lifetime moments. These students were born to make music, and we absolutely had to do everything in our power to make this happen. I was on the elevator the first day with a student. He didn't know me. I did not know him. He looked at me and he said, "Thank you for doing all the work it took to make this happen." I'm a senior and I graduated last week. I would have gone the rest of my life without realizing how truly amazing this All-State Band experience was. I will remember these days forever, and I wanted to thank you for making it happen. A couple of thank yous to Jerry Warden and the entire band staff, band students, and administration here at Melissa for providing this perfect and impressive venue. In our short time working together, I've discovered Jerry is a dreamer of big dreams, and he has been telling us for over a year, "We can do this, guys, we can do this," and he was absolutely correct, because here we are. So thank you to the folks here at Melissa. ATSSB is celebrating its 30th anniversary, and kind of a unique story. Was anybody here 30 years ago when we had the first All-State Band? When the kids came out into the Scottish Rite Auditorium, the crowd started clapping, a standing ovation for those kids just being there. And y'all did the same thing. That was so cool. But only us old timers know about that. So a little bit of history there. We are celebrating our 30th anniversary. We had a celebration luncheon yesterday at the hotel, and it was partially sponsored by Kaleidoscope Adventures. So we would like to thank them for that. Special event at that luncheon yesterday, the executive committee honored our executive secretary, Kenneth Griffin, as the first inductee in the ATSSB Hall of Fame. So when you see him this morning, afternoon, after the concert's over, be sure to tell him congratulations. There's another group of people that we have to thank, and these are the folks that do the heavy lifting, the hard work. Our All-State band organizers, our All-State symphonic percussion organizer, came in at literally the last minute, and she has done an outstanding job, so it's only fair that we recognize her and bring her to the front of the stage. From Melissa High School, Miss Bailey Petersma. And our All-State Symphonic Band coordinator, organizer, Miss Luis Zepeda from London High School. This is his third year to do this, and it takes quite a bit of time and energy, and we thank all of our organizers for that. Our clinician this morning is a truly outstanding individual. Another neat story: when we had our student meeting Wednesday night before tryouts, and I was talking to the students much like I'm talking to you here now, and I was announcing and introducing them to their clinicians. For the symphonic band, I said the name Mr. Brian Balmages, and throughout the whole auditorium, this ripple of ooh kind of went across. And the reason the students had that, or that had an effect on the students, is because since they were in beginning band and through junior high, and even today, his name has been at the top right corner of so many pieces and so much music that they have played, and so they recognize the name and the stories the directors tell, and it has been an amazing experience to watch this man work with these incredible students, and so there's a lot of awards and accolades there listed in your program, and I'm not going to read all those because you came to listen to these students make music, and you are going to be amazed. And so please, welcome to the stage the 2021 ATSSB All-State Symphonic Band, directed by Mr. Brian Balmages.
I promise that contrary to the way it looks, we did have fun for the past 4 days. Those of you that were watching your students or your children go home and ice their fingers, now you get an idea why. That was the easy one. We opened with Danse Diabolique by Helmsberger, arranged by Takahashi. It was a beautiful piece written originally and performed by the Vienna Symphony Orchestra, and this is a wonderful transcription, Vienna Phil. And so this is a wonderful transcription that really moves all of those violin parts into the woodwinds and brass, and they're just there's a lot going on there. And it's really hard to believe that on Wednesday, the vast majority of this was sight reading. And I cannot say enough about their work ethic and everything that they have done. The piece that we're going to perform now, Escenas de los Aztecas by James Barnes. It's a piece that not a lot of people actually know, even though it was written several years ago, because it's published by a publisher in Belgium. It is a wonderful piece that tells the story of the ancient Aztecs and goes through everything from these jaguar themes, moments of worship, into this very mystical encounter in the middle section. There is a section that I think a lot of them love, the human sacrifice. I don't know what that says about them, but I'm going to just leave that one with you. And it's a very engaging, very musical, very descriptive work. And we certainly hope that you enjoy this Escenas de los Aztecas.
Thank you.
wasn't lost on me the circumstances behind everything in the world when I chose to program this next piece by a dear friend of mine, Julie Giroux. This piece, Hymn for the Innocent, is a piece that she wrote for the United States Air Force Band. So of course we can play that. And it was dedicated to Larry Lang, their colonel and conductor at the time. Hymn for the Innocent is a piece that she wrote to honor all of the people in the armed forces, all of those in the military, all of those in police, everybody who has given their lives to protect our way of life, to protect what we have here. It was also written to honor all of those, keep in mind this piece was written years ago, who have lost their lives to disease. And I know that all of us have suffered tremendous loss over the last year. And it is for all of you, whether personal experience, whether related to disease, whether it is to honor a member of your family in the military who is serving overseas now, or to offer somebody who is a first responder who gives so much of themselves and their families give so much. This is for all of you and your families, so I certainly hope that you enjoy this very powerful and moving piece, Hymn for the Innocent.
Thank you.
Sorry. You go for a year without getting the chance to make music, and then you work with kids like that. So before I say anything, I have to acknowledge this incredible organization, this incredible group of people, this group of leaders who refuse to back down when the whole world seemed to be against them, and that is the ATSSB organization. And there's a lot of you here. They're the band directors here that have been working with their kids for whatever restrictions, whatever situations, whatever protocols have been put in place, and they have found a way to give these kids what they so desperately need when everything else is being taken away. And for the board, for Eric Gray, the president, who has vision for this entire thing, for the incredible Kenneth Griffin, who has been about the most amazing communicator, organizer that you could possibly ask for Luis, my wonderful, not only band chairman, but friend, and for every single band director that I have met who has been so gracious, so kind, so appreciative. I think that it is about time that we recognize ATSSB for the incredible organization that it is, and I would be remiss if we didn't even give them a standing ovation for making this happen. I would love to finally close our program with the commissioned work that ATS, by the way, I write music, right? And the piece that we're going to perform, it's a piece called Breaking Through. I got it right, guys. And I wrote this right in the middle of this pandemic. And it was a turning point for me, because it was a moment where I realized there is a way forward. Things are going to come back, and we need to be able to celebrate that. And to have a premiere at an event like this, where we really, I mean, this is what it's all about. It's about having this wall put in front of you, this idea of not being able to move forward, and an organization, a group of young men and women finding a way to push forward. And it's not just about the event, it's not just about the pandemic, it's mostly about the young men and women on the stage, which are going to be the leaders of tomorrow. How do I know it? Because they've given everything they have for 4 days, right? And every time I say, all right, we need to work this through, even though every part of their body hurt, even like muscles they didn't even know they had hurt, they pushed through. They found a way, and they even tried to smile even though their face muscles weren't really responding at that point. And so this piece, Breaking Through, it's a celebration of everything, of everyone. It's a celebration of you parents who pushed and found a way to create some kind of normalcy for your children. It's a celebration of ATSSB, which figured out a way, months away, in a different location, a different time, a different venue, and they found a way to make it happen. And it is a celebration of all of you on this stage who would not let a pandemic get in the way of what you love. We're proud to present the world premiere of Breaking Through. Thank you all so much.
Wasn't it?